The New York Times decided it was important. I mean, they could have selected all sorts of questions, but they decided it was important who was president during the Mexican War. By the way, it was James Polk. I want to get that out of the way. Just so you can forget about it now. But I don't want for the rest of my talk for you to be thinking about that. Nothing a speaker hates so much as a distracted audience. So the Times could have asked an important question about the Mexican War. They could have asked, how did the Mexican War start? Ah. Then they might discover, anybody looking into how the Mexican War started, Mexican War, 1846 to 1848, America goes to war against Mexico, ends up with 40% of Mexico's land, a little war, cleanly fought. Starts with an incident, one of those incidents which start wars, incidents which have a certain amount of deceit attached to them, in which the an attack is fabricated, or exaggerated, or distorted, and suddenly there's a cause for war. And so there was this disputed territory between Texas and Mexico, the area between the Rio Grande River and the Nueces River, and Mexico claimed it for theirs, the United States claimed it for theirs, a clash between the two troops, and immediately, that's it, that's the end, that's enough. President Polk goes to the, announces to the nation, American blood has been shed on American soil. Well, a little bit of an exaggeration. I wasn't sure whether it was Mexican soil or American soil. But American blood has been shed upon American soil. The nation is at war.